Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on Python program for finding the GCD of two numbers. Okay, now this is here we have to write the program and this is the output and we have to trace that program after writing. Okay, so first of all, for finding the GCD of two numbers, first, we have to read the two numbers from the keyboard. Okay. First, we have to start from the output. Enter the first number. That is 60. Next, second one. Enter the second number. That is 45. Okay. So, for finding the GCD of two numbers, first we have to read the two numbers from the keyboard. Okay. First number is 60 and the second number is 45. Now, GCD of two numbers 60 and 45 is 15. Okay, so GCD of 60 and 45 is 15. Okay, first I have to explain the logic. Okay. How to find out the GCD in simple way? Okay. So, for 60, what are the factors of 60? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 12, and 15. So, these are the factors of 60. Okay. Next one. What are the factors of 45? 1, 3, 5, 9, and 15. Okay. So now, among the factors of 60 and 45, what are the common between them? So, 1 is common, 3 is common, 5 is common, and 15 is common. Okay. Among the common numbers between the factors of 60 and 40, what is the greater number? So, here 15 is the greater number. So, 15 is the common divisor of 60 and 40. Okay. So, here 1 is common, 3 is common, 5 is common. Okay. Here 1 is there, 1 is there, 3 is there, 3 is also there, and 5 is there, 5 is also there. Okay. Here 15. 15. Here 15 is there. Among the common elements between 60 and 40 factors, what is the greater number? That is 15. Now, 15 becomes the GCD of 60 and 45. Okay. Here I am writing factors of 60. Here factors of 45. Okay. Here the same number I am not writing. Okay. 60. For the factors of 60, 60 is also one factor. I am not writing here 60. I am not writing here 45. Okay. So, factors of 60 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 11, 12, 15. And factors of 45, 1, 3, 5, 15. Okay. Among the two factors of 60 and 45, what are the common? 1 is common, 3 is common, 5 is common, 15 is common. Among them, what is the greater number? That is 15. So now 15 becomes the GCD of two numbers 60 and 45. GCD means greatest common divisor. Okay, so what are the common divisors between 60 and 40? Among them, greater number, what is there? That is the GCD of two numbers. Okay, next. First, I am writing the how we are accessing two elements from the keyboard. Okay, here A is equal to int of input of enter the first number. Okay, so this statement is used for accessing the first number from the keyboard. Next, we can take another number, int input of enter the second number. Okay, once we are accessing the first number from the keyboard, that can be stored in variable A. Next, we have to access the second number from the keyboard, that can be stored in variable B. Okay, next, print GCD of given two numbers. Two numbers 60 and 45 is comma. Here GCD of, I am writing capital letters, GCD of A comma B. Okay, so this is the main program. In the main program, we have to access the first number from the keyboard, access the second number from the keyboard, and print the GCD of two numbers by using the function GCD of A comma B. Okay, so this is the calling function in the main program. Okay, whenever the calling function in the main program, the control transfer from calling function to called function. Okay, now I am writing the called function. So def GCD of A comma B put colon. Okay, so colon is compulsory. Here the called function name is GCD and the parameters. Here what are the parameters in the calling function? That parameters are called as actual parameters. The parameters in the called function are called as formal parameters. Okay, here the actual parameters are copied into the formal parameters. Okay, so the actual parameters and formal parameters should be the same or are different. There is no problem at all. Okay, next one. If B not equal to 0, colon, return GCD of B comma A modulus operator B. Else colon return A. Return A. Okay. So this is the called function for GCD program. Okay. So the called function is first def, called function name is GCD. Here the two parameters that are formal parameters. Okay. So when we are going to the statements within the function, first one, if B not equal to 0, if this condition is true, then the statements within the if block are executed. Here it is also a GCD. Okay, the same function name is called in the body of the function. Then it is called as a recursion. Recursion means a function called by itself. Okay, the same function name called in the definition of the function, then it can be called as a recursion. If this condition is true, then we have to execute this statement. If this condition is false, then go to the else statement, return A. Whether the condition is true or false, so we have to return some value. Okay, that value can be returned to the main program by using that function, by using the statement called as return statement. Okay, this return statement can transfer the control from called function to calling function. Okay, here the result is stored in the calling function. That result is printed. Okay, so this is our program. Okay, next we go for tracing. So this is the called function or a function definition. These three statements belongs to the main program. Okay, main program is up to this point, and this is the called function and this is the calling function. Okay, now we go for executing the program by using tracing. The tracing starts from the main program. Main program is these three statements. First one, enter the first number. Enter the first number. So what is the number we have to enter? That is 60. Okay. This 60 value can be entered by the user. Okay. That value can be taken by the input function. This input function can read the input that is given by the user from the keyboard. Okay. So then it returns the string of 60. This string of 60 can be typecasted by using int function. This typecasted int function can take the string value 60 and it can be converted into integer 60. Okay, this integer 60 can be assigned to the variable a is equal to 60. Okay, the 60 value can be assigned to the variable a. Next, in the same way, enter the second number. Enter the second number. So what is the second number user entered? That is 45. Okay, this 45 can be taken by the input function. Here the input function can read the value that is entered by the user. So here user enters 45. Okay, and this function returns the value string of 45. This string of 45 is typecasted by the int function. This int function can take the string value 45 and returns the integer 45. Okay, so therefore B is equal to 45. Okay, so after that, print GCD of two given numbers 60 and 45 is, we can call the calling function GCD of A comma B. So here the calling function in the main program is GCD of, what is the A value? A value is 60 and B value is 45. So this is the calling function. The control can be transferred from calling function to called function. Here, what is called function? Here, the called function is def gcd of, here a value is 60 and b value is 45. Colon. Next, go to the statements within that. If, what is the b value? B not equal to 0. What is the b value? B value is 45. 45 not equal to 0. 45 not equal to 0. This is condition is true. 45 not equal to 0. If the condition is true, then return GCD of B comma, B value is 45 comma A modulus operator B. A value is 60. 60 modulus operator 45. 60 modulus operator 45. What is the value we are getting? So that is 60 can be divided by 45. 45 ones, 45. Remainder value is 15. This 15 value is written by the modulus operator function. Okay. So what is that value? So here the value is 15. Okay. So this is a recursive function. Again, the control calls the same function also. So again, it goes to this one. Up to this condition is false. Okay. Again, def gcd of, now 45 comma 15. So this function returns what value? Return gcd of 45 comma 15. Okay. So again it calls a gcd function. So def gcd of a value is b value is 45 and a modulus operator b value is 15. Again the same function is called. Now if b value is 15, 15 not equal to 0. Yes, 15 is not equal to 0. Condition true. If the condition is true, the control goes to the statements within the if block. Return GCD of B. B value is 15, comma, A modulus operator B. A value is 45. 45 modulus operator 15. Okay. So what is the value we are getting? So 45 can be divided with 15. 15 threes, 45, remainder 0. Remainder is 0. So this value becomes 0. Okay. So now again the same function is called. Again the control goes to the same definition. Def GCD of 15 comma, this value becomes 0, colon. Next, if b not equal to 0, b value means 0, 0 not equal to 0. So this is false. Okay, so this statement is false. Then go to the else block. Else, return a. So return a. A value is 15. 15 can be returned. So this 15 can be returned to the calling function. Okay. Now this 15 value is printed. So GCD of so return A is nothing but, so that is 15. 15 is returned. So this is the GCD program. Okay. So once again I am telling. So here the calling function GCD of A comma B, A value 60 and B value 45. So whenever a function is called, the control goes from calling function to called function. Here this is the called function, def GCD of A comma B 60 comma 45. Okay. Now if बी नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, 45 नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, कंडीशन ट्रू. इफ द कंडीशन इज ट्रू द कंट्रोल गोज टू द स्टेटमेंट विद इन द इफ ब्लॉक. सो रिटर्न जीसीडी ऑफ बी वैल्यू इज 45, कॉमा ए मॉड्यूलस ऑपरेटर बी 60, मॉड्यूलस ऑपरेटर 45. That means 60 can be divided by 45. Here remainder value is 15. This remainder value is returned. The modulus operator function returns the remainder value 15. Okay, here the same function is called. Okay, again the control goes to the this one. Def GCD of 45, 15. Now A value 45, B value 15. Okay, now if B value is 15, 15 not equal to 0 as condition true. If the condition is true, the control goes to the statements within the if block. Return GCD B value is 15, comma A modulus operator B, 45 modulus operator 15. So now 45 can be divided with 15, remainder value 0. So this function returns the remainder value. This value is 0. So now return GCD of 15 comma 0. Again the same function is called. The control goes to the called function. So now def GCD of A value is 15, B value is 0. Now goes to the body of the function. If B value is 0, 0 not equal to 0, that is false, then the control goes to the else block. Else return A. Here A value is 15, so that 15 can be returned. 15 is returned. Okay, where it can be returned? From the called function to calling function. So this is called as calling function. So 15 can be returned to the calling function. So now the calling function value is 15 now. So this 15 can be printed. Okay, so this is the calling function and this is the called function. The parameters within the called function are called as formal parameters. The parameters within the calling function are called as actual parameters. The actual parameters are copied into the formal parameters. Once it returns the value, the control goes to this statement again. Now this 15 value is printed. Okay, so this is the description about the GCD of two numbers using recursion. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So Divvela Srinivasarao.